In the book of Genesis, it says God created the sun, the moon, and the stars to give light to the earth. And he said it was good. But in many parts of the world, stars are hard to see because of too much light at night, but not in Tekapo, New Zealand.
It's becoming increasingly difficult to find the dark places on Earth simply because urban light pollution is taking away the stars.
Located in the center of New Zealand's South Island, Tekapo is fighting to preserve its night skies. Hundreds of astro-tourists come each week to the Mount John Observatory to view something that's becoming quite rare in certain parts of the world, stars.
25% of the world's population cannot actually see the stars, not at all, which is a dreadful situation, really. You get a whole generation of children growing up who've never actually seen the sky at all.
In this amazing time-lapse photography, you can see Tekapo's Church of the Good Shepherd under the Milky Way and the Southern Cross, a small but beautiful constellation that can only be seen in the Southern Hemisphere.
Only a small percentage of the world can actually see the Milky Way, but here in Tekapo, New Zealand, they get to see it almost every night.
Well, that is our own galaxy, you might say. That's the one that we're most familiar with, but there are millions, if not billions of stars, anywhere between, I believe, 100 to 500 billion stars within that own galaxy.
From Mount John, you can also observe two neighboring galaxies known as the Magellanic Clouds, each containing billions of stars. But that's not the only work going on here.
The main line of research up here is into the discovery of so-called extrasolar planets, planets going around other stars, stars other than our sun, that is. So to date, we know of around about 330 planets going around other stars.
Guests are awestruck by Tekapo's night sky, like these two young travelers from Ireland.
I thought it was absolutely amazing, I have to say. Especially coming from a city where you don't get to see many stars in the sky, it was absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, it just makes you think that there's so much out there that you don't know. And looking up there, you do feel closer to God, but you're also like, there's so much unknown that you want to learn more about.
During tours of this state-of-the-art facility, astronomers say people often have emotional reactions to seeing the stars.
I remember particularly a couple from Australia just recently who came here, and one of those ladies actually wept with joy at the prospect of seeing the Milky Way for the first time, something she'd never even thought she would see.
In hopes of protecting their night sky for future generations, this town of around 400 people has mandated special lighting, low-energy sodium lamps that are carefully shielded, and household lights that must face down, not up. But they're hoping to go even further by becoming the world's first UN-sanctioned starlight reserve, or what they like to call a park in the sky.
We went to the university and we shared this vision of a park in the sky, which is quite a dubious type of vision to be walking around with. And then suddenly we're at Paris and we're at UNESCO and we're having doors opened and people think, well, that's not such a silly idea.
The idea still faces challenges, as it would be the first time a piece of open sky was designated as a World Heritage Park. But Murray remains hopeful.
It was thought that we may well get success for this initiative in this very important year of celebrating Galileo's 400 years since he first looked through a telescope.
So if this Starlight Reserve is given the go-ahead, Tekapo and Mount John will be kept in the dark for generations to come. And that's exactly the way they like it. Wendy Griffith, CBN News, Tekapo, New Zealand.